ladies and gentlemen. Tonight we are proud to present the Trojan Horseman salute to the armed forces of the United States of America. Today it's choreographed to patriotic music and will recognize all five branches of the armed forces and pay tribute to those veterans who made the ultimate sacrifice while defending our freedom. As the team exits show left, watch as our flight lead releases the two solo pilots. Proud to fly as the honor guard for the Veterans Airlift Command. For compassionate reasons to wounded warriors, veterans, and their families. We use a national network of volunteer aircraft owners and pilots. Go to veteransairlift.org for more operation. For more information, our opposing solo today with the barrel roll. The sailors, the guardsmen, and the airmen, but the families as well. Over 2 million men and women make up the United States Armed Forces, and recognize these strong families and let them know we recognize their sacrifice for their country. I know we probably have a lot of those military families out there in the audience here today. Who right now has a mother, father, brother, sister, son, or daughter serving in the United States Armed Forces? Let me see a show of hands. Everybody, look around you. Look at those raised hands. Let's give a great big round of applause to our military families. As he gives us an aileron roll, pulls the nose up into a half cuban. Trojan Horsemen are the only six-ship T-28 Warbird formation demo team flying in the world today. Our 16-member team consists of former military fighter pilots, instructors, airline pilots, and experienced airshow performers who combined have over 200 years of combined experience. Now, look over, down, speed brakes down, the gear down. As they approach Airshow Center, flight lead will call for an inch of power to come up. Flaps will come up, and at Airshow Center, he will call for the gear to raise. All of the Trojan Horsemen pilots own, operate, and maintain their own aircraft. You're going to notice, unlike some other military teams, we're not all painted alike. Each aircraft is painted in an authentic military paint scheme, representing a unit in which the T-28 once served. Hi, to your left and to your right. Find our two solo pilots as they converge here on Airshow Center for the opposing pass. From the left. Ralph Skydock Lasser, Jason Griffin, two doctors, we like to refer to them as our pair of docs. Beautiful aileron roll right at Airshow Center. Let's give them a great big round of applause. Now, from your left, the Trojan warship in the fingertip right. because our opposing solo passes by. Gives us a nice great big barrel roll. He's going to race to join up with his four teammates. And we're going to give the sky to our lead solo, Ralph. And Doc is going to show us the graceful side of this loud, powerful airplane.
Just my children and my wife.
Doc's going to perform 1.5 Cuban eights for us. And as right now, he's going to add an aileron roll in the upline. Veterans Airlift Command was founded by one of our members, Walt Fricke. Walt is a decorated helicopter pilot in Vietnam, and he was severely wounded. While recovering in a hospital over 700 miles from home, he said his healing really didn't begin until his family gathered the resources to make the trip to visit him. That realization stayed with him and was a seed that grew into the Veterans Airlift Command. These strong young military families, we want to bring them together. We want to speed the healing process. We're going to use a formation term here today, and that's to ask you to join on our wing. Help us put these military families back together as they're going through this tragic time. Thousands of families have been helped and millions of volunteer miles have been flown. Please visit our website, veteransairlift.org. Find out about this organization. Find out how you can help. Or find me after the show and I'll tell you how the average person can help this fabulous organization.
Across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston.
Ladies and gentlemen, as this song says, I am proud to be an American. How about you guys? Show me your American pride out there. Let me hear some of it here this morning. Oh, yeah, I can hear you. Now look, as Jason is joining the four ship, and I give you the five ship Trojan Horseman Delta. Out in front of the crowd here and keep that turn coming around, and in a few minutes we're going to give you a really great photo opportunity. So I'm going to give you fair warning, those of you photographers out there, get those cameras out and get ready, because we are going to give you a great big surprise. Hello. Now watch, look. Flying number 8 is Malta Dipstick Malt. From Long Island. I'm from Port St. Lucie, Florida. My team's a Trojan Horseman. We're really, really happy to be here today. We want to ask you, photographers in the audience, your pictures. Tell us what we thought of the performance here today. We would love to see your pictures, and we'd hope.
Paying attention on that. I hope you enjoyed it. Stick by. We're going to see some more. We're going to see some more of that. You're going to get some entertainment here from the Trojan Horsemen as the firefighters are out.
Oh my God, it's been a ride!
What you're witnessing now is the aircraft coming back. The brief was to go over and hold in a particular area, wait for the emergency to be done. They gave you some flyovers while they were doing it, and they recovered the aircraft, and everything looks good. So I'd like you to give everybody a big round of applause for handling these multiple events as a daily routine. What a great job by all the pilots and the air crew involved. A great big hand for the fire department and everything that they did to go out there and get that fire out, and in the meantime, recover these aircraft. So thank you very much to everybody involved.
All about?
Sure, Frank. The L-39 Albatross, it was developed and built in Czechoslovakia as a trainer, a jet trainer during the 1960s. And there have been 2,800 of them produced, and they've served in 30 air forces around the world. It's the most widely used jet trainer in the world. And actually, they're available pretty cheap. You can buy one for about $700,000. I see that's how then keeping it going and maintaining it is something else. But this one is being flown by Art Knowles, 0.8, Mach 0.8, or 609 miles per hour. We'll probably see it getting pretty close to that as it makes a pass around here today.
Ladies and gentlemen, what you're just witnessing here is the recovery from all the guy behind them to give them plenty of room to land. It was done in a very precise manner, just as you would see on any military base when you're recovering multiple plane formations. So I can't stress enough how great these guys are, having other jobs, not doing it every day, but they look like pros that do it every day out there.
They're all flying a T-28 Navy trainer. Got a 1,200 horsepower motor in it. Very powerful airplane.
You're waving at you. Have a big round of applause. Big horseman. Spectacular show here at Culpeper Air Fest. A tribute to the United States Air Force, United States Marine Corps, United States Navy.